Okay, I want to talk about grinding in RPGs. I've mentioned this before a few times, not the fact that I love RPGs, but the fact that I actually don't mind grinding, and I'll explain why. Maybe you find it interesting, but I just want to talk about the whole thing in general. A lot of people detest it, and I can understand why. I can. Make no mistake about it, I do understand why people don't like it. In fact, there have been a few RPGs I didn't like the way you had to grind, because more just the way the RPG was, the, you know, the systems it had and functions. Whereas compared to other ones where it was pretty much, you know, just mashing buttons, and even then it was a little bit easier, not as frustrating, I guess. Or you didn't have to do it as much, or it wasn't as just annoying to do, and it didn't take as long. There's that too, but I'll get to that when I talk about why it doesn't bother me and how I do it and why that leads it to not bother me. But whatever. A lot of people don't like it because it takes a long time, it's very tedious, it's very boring, whereas they think, you know, I could be playing the damn game right now, which is true. There's a lot of RPGs that require this, and by the way, the only ones I'm really talking about here are ones that actually legitimately require grinding. There's a lot of people who think every RPG requires you or expects you to grind. That's not true. In fact, pretty much any RPGs made now don't, and that's done intentionally. I kind of miss it, but whatever, that's just because I'm used to it. Something like, say, Mass Effect 1. That game does not require you to grind. Can you grind if it doesn't require you to? Yeah, you can do that in pretty much any game. Hell, you can do that in games that aren't even RPGs. I could do that in this game you're seeing here. But whatever, you know, I do that in racing games for money, like Gran Turismo. Grinding is grinding. But really, I'm just talking about RPGs here. The other argument to this is, along with, I could just be playing the game right now instead of wasting my time doing this. Again, I understand what you mean, is that, you know, they could be finding more about the story because, you know, they're playing probably like a 100-hour RPG or something like that, and then you come to this point where you have to grind. It doesn't, like, the game doesn't tell you, you must do this now for 30 hours or whatever. Again, it's not 30 hours, but their thing is, like, you know, how much time is being wasted, and this basically brings the whole entire game to a halt. It grinds to a halt, really. And again, I understand that too. In fact, that's pretty much, if I had to pick something that would bother me about grinding, that would be it. The fact that it basically brings the entire game to a halt. Everything is put on hold according to the story. Like, people just wait around for you to do whatever you're doing, and then it progresses. That's actually a very common thing that's weird in pretty much all games, where, like, say a hub world like Wolfenstein 2009, the entire world basically goes on hold while you just go around doing whatever the hell you want. It's very strange. But anyway, back to this. The way I do it, so it doesn't bother me, before I go back to the other part, just take any RPG that basically requires you to grind, or I chose to do it. Here's what I do. I usually turn the sound off entirely for the game, or I just turn the sound effects off and just leave the music if I like the music a lot. Or I turn the sound off completely, like in the case of like really old games where you can't adjust individual sound volumes or whatever. That's, you know, too specific. I play my own music. I listen to something. Maybe I listen to people talking, like these podcast things. I watch something on the TV. If it's a simple enough RPG where I can actually just mash the button literally over and over and not worry about dying, then I can just not have to watch it, but every now and then I'll go back to it, or I'll listen to the radio, or I'll do something, or I actually can read at the same time. I'm good at multitasking. Some people aren't, but whatever. But most of the time what I do is I listen to something. I listen to music, I listen to like some kind of podcast of people talking, or, you know, stuff like that. I think that's probably the best way to go about it. Now, really, overall, from ever since I first dealt with this kind of stuff, despite the fact that it doesn't bother me, and I actually kind of like grinding, it's not because it's a nostalgia thing for me, it's just something about it I actually kind of enjoy. Maybe it's because I know that all this time I'm putting into it will be worth, you know, in the end. Say, like, Final Fantasy VII, you're grinding for that, you'll have all the best magic spells, you'll be powerful enough to deal with everything up to the final boss, and it won't make the game extremely easy to the point where there's no point in playing it, you know, it's not going to be just like a pushover. You still will have times where you're going to have resistance to what you're doing, and you still have to think and use strategy and stuff like that, you know. Although there are some RPGs, I've played good, bad, indifferent, all that kind of stuff, famous, not famous. And most of the time with these ones, even if it's a good one, the grinding usually sometimes does result in you being way overpowered. That's another complaint people have too. But again, this is referring to ones that are requiring grinding, and man, did I come close to hitting that guy there. To be honest, I really don't understand why they feel the need to basically make it a requirement. It's basically an invisible requirement. As I said, no RPG I know of that I've ever played ever transparently says right in the damn game, or the character says it, or just tells you the manual or anywhere else, that it says, in order to be even remotely survive from this point on, you must grind. All these games that are basically what I'm calling required, they're very obvious. In fact, pretty much all these ones that are like this, they're well known at this point. It's not hard to find out which ones are. In fact, the majority, if not all, the main series Final Fantasy games are like this, just using that as an example. Final Fantasy X, let's just use that one as an example. That one is definitely expected of you to grind. Final Fantasy, is it 6 or 8? Yeah, 8. I'm trying to figure out which one I'm talking about. Final Fantasy 8 expects you to do it too, with the magic junctioning spells and stuff like that. Spoonie bitched about that one a lot. But overall, if you find something you can do while you're doing it, it will make it less of a pain. I'm just saying. So keep that in mind. Like, listen to music or do something else. But yeah, I understand exactly what you mean if you say grinding is horrible and annoying. Believe me, I can understand. In fact, when I first was playing RPGs for a while, I actually did not like grinding. So I was like the majority. But then for some reason, whatever reason it is, I eventually adapted to it and I got used to it, and, you know, same thing with JRPGs, I got used to the way they are, and that's why I prefer those more than any other kind. Although I'll pretty much play any damn kind of RPG, so I just love the genre that much. But basically this is all I want to talk about, like why grinding doesn't bother me. I've mentioned it many times before and haven't made anything talking about exactly why it doesn't bother me and how I get around that, why it bothers other people, and so on and so forth. There's a lot of people, it's kind of like anime, RPGs aren't for everyone, and this is just one of the reasons with RPGs why it's not. So that's all. Thanks for watching and listening, please like the video if you liked it, and tell me what you think about grinding and all that. I will see you next time.